गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो फोर स्टूडेंट्स हैव जॉइंड टिल नाउ, सो लेट्स वेट फॉर सम वन और टू मिनट्स मोर एंड देन वी विल स्टार्ट आवर क्लासेस। Okay, so a good morning to all of you again. So this is the first class of seventh semester. Okay, so the topic today we are going to discuss, that is your subject machine learning again. Okay, because again you people have this machine learning topic, and if you have go through the syllabus, I hope all of you have checked the syllabus. So among all the subjects, means whatever the subjects, okay, let me first show you the subject, just a minute. Okay, so among all the subjects, you will have artificial intelligence as a core subject. It is mandatory for all. Now coming to the part of professional elective 3 and 4 and open elective 3 and 4. So in open elective 4, we have choose the cryptography. Open elective 3, that is values and ethics, right? Because software engineering was done, information security is a part of the network and cryptography, that is a related part. Now coming to the professional elective 3 and 4, that is in three professional elective 3, there are options, that is human computer interaction, multimedia and application, and machine learning. So I think it is the best to learn machine learning because other two are not so much effective for this particular trend. Human computer interaction, that is a part of machine learning, and so to learn machine learning we can cover that part also. And multimedia application is not related to current trending techniques now. So that's why we have choose this machine learning from this professional elective 3. Okay. So and I know that you have artificial intelligence also in this semester, and you have already learned the machine learning topic in your previous semester, right? Because in sixth semester, you people have already studied it. But to keep in mind, we have already studied that particular machine learning in professional in sixth semester. So one more reason is to choose that because it is your seventh semester and you are in the final year. You people need to focus on other placement scenario. You people need to crack a job. So you people need some time for that, right? So you have already the idea of machine learning, as you have the idea, we have already discussed about it. So as you have already the idea of the subject, it will be very helpful to learn it, to cope up with this subject easily. So to think with it, and I have suggested to take this subject again. So if you people have anything to say, if you want to choose any other subject in between this multimedia application, human computer interaction and machine learning, you people can suggest. Okay, so I will ask for your opinion. This is my opinion. To thinking from your end, to as you focus, need to focus on other subjects, other placement scenarios, other job opportunities. So you people need to prepare for that also. So that's why I think that it is better to learn or study the subject which you have the knowledge already. So what is your opinion? You people can say it. If you want to choose any other subject between multimedia and human, people can tell me. Otherwise, we will go with the machine learning. suggestions? Any? All are in a silent mode. Am I audible to all?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think I'm not audible because I'm not getting any response to suggestions from you people. So I can think that you are all are okay with the machine learning.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
Fine. So no issue on that. So let's start our topic of machine learning. And some of you have already cracked your job, you secured your job in some companies. So congrats to you people that you have already secured your opportunity, you have already secured your job. So congratulations on that. Okay, but don't shift from your focus because there is one more year you have to complete. And as far as my concern, as I remember, checking into the background of the previous years, the final year exam will be happening in offline. Okay, previous years, previous semesters, the offline exam have happened for the final year. So as you people have passed out your previous semester by not giving any type of exam, so be ready, be prepared to face the offline exam this time. Because in seventh semester, you people have to give your exam offline. Because in eighth semester, there is only one thing, that is a project. There is nothing more than that. Okay, I can show you this, that in eighth semester, you people only one subject, that is a project, and it is full of 200 marks. So no theoretical things, no practicals, nothing there is. So that's why the last offline exam you people have to give here. So study hard for this time. Don't think that, okay, we can easily manage it. Okay, it is not like that. This time you will need to study with lot more energy to crack or to secure a good mark in your offline exam. Okay, that is the information I want to share. So let's move to the topic of machine learning. So we have already discussed a lot. We have already discussed a whole 6 to 7 months on this machine learning topic. So again, starting from the topic that we have now in our syllabus, that is, what is the machine learning? We all know that machine learning is a simple program to optimize or to get something, to learn something from the data, to probably to think something, to build a model, to achieve some output, to predict something, right? So that is a part of the machine learning. So if a definition is set up here, then what is the definition we can talk about in the machine learning? That is, it is said this machine learning is a computer program, we can say it, by which it is learning from the experience. So experience means the past experience on a particular data, on a particular topic. So the experience to learn something from the past experience, that is mentioned here as E. That is mentioned here as E with respect to some class of task. So some task is present here, means we have learned from the experience, we are trying to learn from the past experience. Some task is assigned first. So when we have some task, to do that particular task, we do a research. Means what are the scenarios, what are the things I've done in the past. So to learn from the past, for the given task that is mentioned here as T, and for the performance measure as P. So this P is our performance measurement, or as the output we can say, that we need to achieve, that we need to predict. So to predict or to achieve that particular goal, to our the output, we need some data, we have a task, and to work with the task, work with the data to finish the task, we have some idea, we need some idea. That idea we are getting from our past, experiences. So this is a basic definition of a learning. Right? So if we think that learning, we can understand, we cannot understand anything about this machine learning if we don't know the computer programs previously, if our, in our current semester, if we don't know C, if we don't know Java. Now, let's go much behind, much past. That is, we will not be able to understand any of this if we don't have the idea of math, if we don't have the idea of the numbers, if we don't have the idea of the letter. So to learn something new, what is helping us? Our previous education, our previous study. So it is not like that the previous study is not needed. So all the things are connected in the education field, in the job field. When you people in the job field, those who have already secured their job, when they are going to enter into the field, the means the practical field, the practical work scenario, what happens there. So you people can relate that whatever we have studied in the past, maybe all the things are not useful. It happens. Okay. So there you need to learn something new. You need to cope up with that new thing. But to cope up with that new things, to learn that new things, you need a knowledge, you need an idea that you are gathering from your this 4 year BTech life, right? So there you need to learn some new language, also new code, new coding language, new coding programs. But to learn that, to understand that coding, to learn that new technology, you need the basic knowledge of coding that you have achieved from your past experiences. The past experiences means the BTech life. So this is the definition of learning, right? So a simple definition by a simple example I am trying to give you people. Okay. So here are some example is given. One example, a very interesting example is here, that a chase learning problem. Chase learning problem. Okay. So all of us have the idea of this chase game. But how we achieve that idea? Because if I, after getting into the, means after have some knowledge to learn something, to know something, at the age of 3 or 4, I say, if I give a child a chase board with all the keys, all the things, he will, or she will not be able to do anything. Because to play with that game, to play chess, we need to know the logic behind chess game, how the thing is going on, how much shift we can done with each of the cards or each of the board, right? So we need to learn it. We need to have the knowledge. So how a child will get the knowledge? The child will get the knowledge either from its parents, from its elder brother, if any, or any of the person who already knows the game. The person who already knows the game will help the child to learn about it. Now, the child have learned about the game. The child have the basic knowledge about the game. Then what comes? When the child is playing, when the person is playing with other opponent. So now, he needs to play with his brain. He needs to find out that how the opponent is playing, and the person needs to think or to cultivate his game plan. So that is a learning. The person have learned the knowledge, and then he is applying his own brain or own game plan to defeat the opponent. So that is a very interesting example, very self or the live example we can say. That is helping to understand this learning much better. Each of the experiment, each of the things is a real life example by which we can understand that to learn something, we need some basic knowledge, but not in all the cases. Some things we can learn from ourselves, that for that we don't need any experience, but a little experience is needed in all the scenarios. Somewhere it needs a large number of experience. Sometimes it needs a little bit of experiences that will help us to learn the thing properly. Right. So the definition we have already talked about, that a computer program which learns from the experience is called a machine learning program or a learning program. So what are the components? So we can see a diagram here that is components of a learning process. The data, concept, inferences, and the evaluation. So data is for the data storage. So data storage means huge number of data is present in today's scenario. The data for any task, whether it can be a math, whether it can be a science, whether it can be English, whether it can be a Bengali, whether it can be a Hindi, whether it can be a numerical, anything, whether it can be biology, history, geography, ABCD, whatever it is, it gathering all the things in a single place, we have a huge number of data present in our current scenario. That is called the data storage. Concept. As I just give you the example of the chess game, we have the knowledge, we have the basic data idea of the things, but then we need to put our concept also there to defeat the opponent. So that's come the concept where you have the previous concept and as well as to for with the synchronization of the previous concept, we are putting our concept also, we are using our brain also to achieve that particular task. And inferences or the generalization to things, make the things very easy, make the things very easy to achieve the target. And then the evaluation. Evaluation means the outcome, whether it can be predicted correctly, whether we are getting our results correctly, whether we are achieving our goal successfully. So this is the four basic components: data storage, abstraction, generalization, and evaluation. These are the four basic concepts for the machine learning. So here the terms have been described: the data storage, what is the data storage, what is the abstraction, what is the generalization, and what is the evaluation. So I have already described you people this type of thing, so no need to go through that. Next, what are the applications of machine learning? So machine learning is related to the data mining part also, because we are trying to feed the data, we are trying to feed that model, we are trying to feed the data into the particular model to achieve the goal. So it has a huge application in today's world. Huge application in today's world. What are the applications? That is one of the finest example we can say for the machine learning application: stock market. Every day, every minute, every second, the stock market goes up and down. Some companies' share have increased, some companies' share have decreased, some have lost their all the things, some have achieved a huge number of, right? So that is a prediction, totally a prediction, that which team, which company share will go up, which company have a huge profit, which company have a huge loss. So we need to predict, and after predicting the particular thing, then we need to put the value there. We are investing our money there. So if it is, if my prediction is totally correct, if my prediction is correct, getting corrected, then we may have some profit. Otherwise, if my prediction gets wrong, then we will be in a loss. So stock market is a very finest example of the machine learning example, right? Also, any type of things, prediction, whatever the things are related to prediction, that is the machine learning part or the prediction part. Also, we are trying to buy something from the Flipkart, Amazon, as Durga Puja, Diwali, all the things are going on simultaneously. Flipkart Big Billions offers are going on, Amazon Festival Diwali's offers are going on. So what you people can see, that I want to buy something. So before buying that, I want to search about that particular product in Google, okay, whatever platform. But then after searching that particular product in the Google, we often get to see the products related to it in every particular scenario. If we are opening Flipkart, the scenario comes into the scenario, that these are the things suggestion for you. Facebook, in the retail market of the Facebook part, these are the things suggestion for you. So how this thing happened? Because this happens only when you are logging with a particular account, and that account is predicting that you have searched for this item, so you may need, you wish to buy something like this. So all the related suggestions regarding that particular item will be in your display all the time. It will get it. So this is a prediction. The thing will be predicted, and related to that prediction, all the outcomes, all the results will be displayed into the diagram, all the things. Okay. These are the particular machine learning. There are whole lot of examples are given. There are 10 I can see already. So no need to discuss. Okay, if we just think from our end, we just think from our practical life, the real life example, there is n number of real life examples related to our machine learning, right? So all the things in today's world are a part of machine learning, or it is growing very fast. It is growing very fast, and now the robotics have come into the scenario also. Now, this machine learning example we are talking about, there is a part that is a model. We need to build a model that can predict our result successfully. Now, the success means we are not the 100%. In machine learning, the 100% success rate is not, till now is not achievable. Okay, 99.99 is okay, but 100% is complex, because prediction means we cannot predict it totally. There is some bit of error will be there. So to predict that particular thing, there will be some models that is going on, or that we need to develop. Now the models can be developed using these 3 or 4 particular things. That is the logical expression, the geometrical models, the probabilistic models, and the grouping or grading. This grouping or grading means basically the regression and these particular things, the generalization and these particular terms. Okay, we will discuss. So this logical models. The logical models are saying that is, we have a space, we have a large number of data sets. To break that into the segments, and construct a grouping model. So these logical models are a logical expression to divide the instance spaces into the segments and construct a grouping model. So in a basket, there are 10 balls with different colors. So we need to apply some logic to identify or to separate that, to separate the similar kind of balls into a particular. So what are the logic behind we are going to use? A very simple logic, the color. Or if the colors are same, then the shape, something like this. Okay. So as it is a ball, it will be round. So the colors will be the main key identifier for the grouping of that particular ball. So these are the logics. So whatever the things is going on, we need to apply some logic to create or to make it happen. So some logical models have the logical expressions also. Some have some Boolean, that is a true false outcomes maybe. So these are the types of logics, whatever the logic we have learned from our previous third, fourth semester, that is in the logical expression of digital electronics, this type of particular scenario. The logics will come into the scenario to solve or achieve our logical model problems. So there are mainly 2 types of logical models is given, that is a tree model and another one is a rule model. Tree model and rule model. So this rule model consists is only of the implication of if then rule. So we have done a lot more program in if else program. In C, in Java, in Python, we have done all the things. If else program, if then, if it is happened, then what will be not, if not, then else part. So this if else part example is the part of this logical models, the logical expression of the tree models, rule models actually. So this rule models is the part of the logical expression or this if else part. This not is needed actually. Okay. by seeing this diagram, I just come up with an example. My mind just get up by example, weather forecast. This is a simple example of weather forecast. So how this weather forecast was done? One more example, we can say if we go for IRCTC site, train booking. Okay, so there is a thing that is given, the percentage of confirmation, chances of confirm booking. Okay, if my seat is in waiting list to book, when I'm going to book a waiting list seat, there is showing it's the chances, confirmation chances. So how it is showing, how it can be done? So it is done from its previous past experiences. So what happens there? The past records that up to, for IRCTC, I am saying, up to this particular waiting list, the seats have been confirmed. Up to this particular waiting list, the seats was confirmed. Okay. So this is a prediction that IRCTC sites are using. But that does not guarantee that if previous year at the waiting list 52 gets a confirmation, it may not get confirmation in this year 52, when waiting list will be 52. It is a prediction. Okay, so if it is showing that at the waiting list 52, it is having a chances of 95% confirmation, then it may happen. But if it is not happening, if it is not happening actually, then we cannot argue with that, because it is a prediction. Prediction on the basis that in previous 4 to 5 years, up to this particular scenario, if my waiting list is 40, then it is giving hints that yes, in previous 5 years, the waiting list 40 gets the confirmation. But if it is not happening this year, then it may not be, because it is possible when my previous waiting list person or those who have a confirmed seat is canceling the seat, and then the waiting list gets a chance to confirm. So it is depending on the person. So this year, maybe the person is not getting canceled. So that's why maybe the waiting list 40 is not getting a confirmation. So this is a prediction. Similarly, the weather forecast also, in previous 4 to 5 years, what happened on this particular day, how much rain is there, how much perception, how much humidity, how much sunny is the thing, all that is, how much warm is it. All the data is there, so making a prediction on that. But this year, for the upcoming 4 to 5 days, upcoming 1 month, upcoming 1 week, all the prediction is given there. That doesn't mean that the prediction is totally right. So it may happen, it may not happen. So it is a prediction. These are the example of this machine learning. All the things are real life example we are dealing with. Any doubts up to this particular part?
No, sir.
Okay, fine. So moving to the part that is our geometric models. Geometric models means a geographical domains, or the geometrical example, that is X, Y, Z, this part of particular thing. So this geometrical models will a part of this logical model. We have seen the logical model to make a decision tree. So this logical expression is used in this space also. So we have a coordinates, X, Y, Z coordinates. We have a 3D space, we have a 2D space, right? So this geographical models will put that logical expression into the space, into a domain space, 2D model, 3D model, to show the output. So if we just go back to the sixth semester, we have seen a lot of graphs. So these are the part of geometrical models, that are the graphs. We can use this geometrical graph concept in the planes, in the lines, to achieve the linear model, to get the proper visualization of the linear model. That is called the geometrical models. And also the linear models is there. This is the example, and again a graph to show a particular thing, to carve to draw a card to see something. These are the parts that is given. Distance means mortens means we have learned this distance example, that is the Euclidean model, that is the Manhattan model. So the distance between the two points, distance between the two points. So when you are drawing, when we are actually plotting some graph, there are some points are there. So all the points need to be connected. So what are the distance between the points? We can also calculate that. And what are the there are some expressions given. So what are the expressions? The expression is given by this some Euclidean model, some Manhattan model. So these models or the expression will helping us to get the distance also, right? So these are the parts. There is some totally k-means clustering algorithm, nearest neighbor algorithm. These are the things that is helping us to achieve or to predict our output successfully. These are the models, probabilistic models are there. These are the models is given. So probabilistic model has some rules that is called as a bias rule, that is the probability of A by B. That is means the things are set up here, A and B, and to the given example, the expression is given by probability of B by A, of probability A and B. So given example for our expression, mathematical expression is given there. Some distribution, joint distribution, probability is given, some predictive and genetic partial quotients are there. So all the things have a particular expression, and this expression is put into the have been used in this machine learning. That is called a naive bias algorithm, naive bias classifier algorithm. Actually, that is in the part of your syllabus. We will study it in deeply. All the expressions, all the things we will do some problems on that also, as previous year we've also done this. So these are the examples. As this is a basic where I'm just giving the hints. We will do this type of particular things. We will have a discussion on this in a large part. Grouping and grading, we have done this. We have talked about this. So no need to do it again. Now designing a learning system, going for the particular diagram, designing a learning system, it is an important part that we have a data set. Fine. We have a trained data set now. So data set is classified into two parts, trained and test data set. So trained data set means the data have some prediction with the previous past example. Test data set, the data we need to test and to achieve a result. So these two data sets are there, a function, and then we need to build a model with the help of this learning algorithm. So which learning algorithm is best for my model, we need to find out. And hypothesis which need to be created, and then the result or the outcome comes into the scenario. So three or four basic parts are there, right? First one, we can say the data sets. That can be divided into two parts, train and test data set. Then the model and which algorithm is suitable for my model, that is also needs to be there. Then the hypothesis, the logics, the codes, all the things need to be there. So elements, that is a task, performance measure, and training experiences. With the help of these three particular things, we can build or we can design a learning system to achieve a particular output or to get a performance measure. Okay, so up to this particular part, we are going to have a discussion today, because in this particular part, we are going to learn a new, means not new because it is already new to you people. So going to discuss the things. So up to this particular part, this model we have discussed. And I think this is enough for the day one, because we have also a class of cryptography today that will be taken by me in the second half from 3 p.m. So we will have a discussion of cryptography also on there. Okay, so welcoming you all back into the daily classes. So that is all for the day one. So the thing is that those who are present, as you will know or maybe not know, LMS is down for some particular technical reason. So the attendance and the note share is not possible at this particular moment. So kindly you people put your names in the chat box for the attendance purpose, and the record is available, will be available in short, in a few minutes by today, under the departmental YouTube channel, where you can go and get the videos of the class. Okay, so you people write your names in the chat box for the attendance proper. Okay, so I hope all of you have write their names in the chat box. One more thing, one more information regarding the project. That is, project is a major thing for you people in your 8th semester, also in the 7th semester. So the grouping and the topics, all the things will be informed shortly, you people. But the thing is that this year, in previous year also, I mean for your senior batches for 2021, we have done some practical, means the real life oriented problems, right? So in this year we are trying to implement that fully, that all the things will be some real life practical based for project, and no, the website designing and this type of project will not be the considered. Okay, till we have a discussion, but not yet finalized. When it will be finalized, all the things will be informed via notice to you people, all the things will be clear. But those who are going to be by means under my project group, they are going to do the project on machine learning. Okay, because I don't prefer any other things, as I like to be with the current training technique. So I also like to train the students, to habituate the students with the current training topics, so that will be beneficial for all. So that's why those, the project group will be decided later on after the notices and all the things, what are the process, all the things will be briefly described to you people. So from my end, my project group, who will be the part of my project group, whatever the groups or the people, no issue on that, we'll have to do a project on machine learning domain. So need to build up something. So previously in the last year, the group of RIAP and this particular group, RIARAT group, they have done a project on attendance based, means real life, means live example, live attendance with the help of this machine learning. Okay, so that is a